This is a USB study. I'll just talk about it again. It's 8 locations, 7 states, ranging from Indiana, Missouri, Arkansas, Tennessee, Ohio, Indiana, Illinois. And what we've done is we're looking at 4 tillage types, deep tillage, which is moldboard plow, followed by a spring pass of field cultivator, conventional tillage, which is chisel plow, followed by spring pass of field cultivator, a minimum tillage, which is a Case IH turbo tools, what we've used here, and then a no-till treatment. And then within those tillage treatments, we've got 2 herbicide programs, one being a residual herbicide program and one being a post-only program. And what you can see on page 30 is that the field counts that we've done for this show that a residual herbicide program does better across the board than a post-only program. Something that Dr. Bradley's talked about a lot is making sure that you have a residual down, and that's something that we've seen in this study. And the other thing that it shows is that a deep tillage treatment alone does better than no tillage treatment. And what that's doing is when you go through with a moldboard plow in the fall, you're turning that soil over and you're burying that weed seed down, and then it doesn't have the potential to germinate, and that's what we're seeing in our counts. The other side of it is the soil profile data. So if you want to turn to page 31, you'll see the graph for this. So what we've done is we took 192 soil cores, basically to be able to capture the soil profile in each plot, and then we plant, every university sent that to me that's taken part in the study, they plant it out in the greenhouse, and we cut this. And this is 1 centimeter, and then 1 to 5, so basically, if you want to talk in inches, 2 inches, 2 inches, 2 inches, 2 inches, 2 inches, going from the top of the soil, working your way down. We grew this out to be able to tell where in the soil profile this weed seed was being distributed. If you look at these two alone, no-till, a lot of it's right here in this top 4 inches, most of it being in the top 2 inch line ending right here. Whereas deep tillage, the majority of that is below the 2 inches. And so that's showing up in not only our soil profile data, which is on that graph there, showing you the percentage of the number of seeds that we've counted in the greenhouse from last year. That's across 3 sites, both sites in Missouri, and that was SIU, Illinois. And we're seeing that that deep tillage treatment is moving this weed seed down farther in the soil profile, and that's allowing us to have less weeds emerge and better amaranthus control in the across the season, and which we're seeing in the field counts, which was the graph on page 30.
What we're doing is using this as a measurement of how many is down in there, but the key is the water hemp that's down in this 6 and 8 inch down in here are not going to come up. Now we took soil cores and we cut those cores into 2 inch segments, and we spread these little 2 inch segments to get an idea of how many water hemp seed are in each segment. But in the real world, in the 6 and 8 inch, what we want you to do is leave them down there for 4 years. They will die, they won't be viable anymore, they won't come up.